Wherever you are listening from, welcome on the program. Today is Sunday, the 31st of January, 2001. Well, the last day of the first month of 2001. The year 2001. Sorry. Okay. Remember to invite your friends. I don't know why this is echoing. Remember to invite your friends, your family, invite your enemy, invite them to come and join the show today. All right. We are back on air, like I said last week, Sunday. We are back on air now. So we are broadcasting live from United Kingdom. You know, we start from 5 p.m. here in UK, which is 6 p.m. in Nigeria. I don't know what time is it in your country where you live. But check your time, but well, here is 5 p.m. In UK, and I want to say thank you so much for joining me. I want to apologize for coming on late. You know, I don't want to say too much. Guests always make us come late on the show, not us. So we're always ready. It's just hard to get hold of them with their network and internet and everything. So that's always the issue. I want to say, please. I said something last week that we will be having some programs, you know, we have adjusted a little bit of our show so that it can make you happy, so that you can get everybody along, so they can understand what we say and can take part as well. So if you are there watching us and then you want to be on the show, please, there's a phone number on the screen. If you cannot call, just text. I will respond to you, or the team will respond to you. Then we arrange how we can get you on the show. Okay, so from today, this month, January to June 2021, we'll be giving a time giveaway. And what you need to do just to listen to the phrase of the day. So what you need to do, in fact, the how to get the answer, how to answer, how to claim, everything is on the screen rolling. So just listen, because I'm gonna say something now. So you just have to make sure you get the correct answer so they can get the it's not. And okay, so here comes the verse of the day. Happy New Year. So I've just said it something. So if you heard it, so just post this the answer, so that I'll be able to know. I want to say, MC a comedian, Prime. I don't know who's that. Thank you for joining me today. Number one across TVC. I don't know who is that. Anyway, thank you so much, all of you, for joining me today. And you can see on the screen here, we have, we're hanging out today with Uwome Dimo. You know, Uwome Dimo is from Akwa Ibom State. He lives in Lagos or Abuja, which of the anyone. Anyway, you kill me when he comes. Okay. So today we'll be talking about, you know, we look, just look inside now, inside Akwa Ibom and Nigeria, because without Nigeria there will be no Akwa Ibom. So this is what people ask me to be doing, and I'm doing it now. You said we shouldn't be talking about only Akwa Ibom, that when they were asking where is Akwa Ibom, but when we talk about Nigeria, you also say, okay, this Akwa Ibom come from Nigeria, or they came out from Nigeria or whatever. So that's what I'm doing now. So Uwome Dimo will be here with me very soon. He's texting me, say it's Abuja, not Lagos. Don't forget that story. Okay, I've heard you. Okay, is that nice. Thank you so much for joining. Godwin Ezekiel, thank you. MC Comedian, thank you. Joshua John, thank you so much for coming. Please remember to share the live broadcast. Let people know that we are on A. Like I said, I said something in the beginning of the show. I don't know, we said we are giving out A time. So I thought a lot of people didn't hear. Maybe let me say it again for the last time. Happy New Year. So that's the verse of the day. So if you get it right, just text it on the live chat, that I'll be able to, I'll first come, first serve, you know? You know what I mean? So that's what I have to say. Mbogo Emmanuel, thank you for in the Carbon State, which I'm following. Thank you so much, Mbogo. Okay. We don't want to waste too much of our time, because we started late and we have a few minutes to be here and before we pack up. All right, we just want to go on a musical. By the time we come back, I hope you'll be coming back with our guests. And he won't be on video today because the network, he has a bad network. So he's gonna join us through WhatsApp. So I hope we'll be able to communicate very well. So thank you so much, guys. All right, after the music, I give you praise. And thank you for inviting people to join us. I can see a lot of people are posting answers and everything. Just waiting. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to announce the winner at the end of the show. So I think we're now connected to our guest today, Mr. Womedi Imo. He stays in Abuja. So not Lagos. So pardon me for that, in Abuja. To joining us today live. How are you, Mr. Womedi Imo?
Very fine, Edna.
How are you?
I'm very fine. Happy New Year, Edna.
Happy New Year. Is it?
Yeah,
I just hope people are hearing you. Anyway, so how is Nigeria today?
Beautiful, as always. Africa is a very beautiful place, you know. Nigeria, mother of all.
Okay. All right, so today we are talking about we're going to be looking at inside Akwa Ibom in Nigeria. First of all, let's talk about our state. So this is 2021. You know, we expect a lot from our government to do something for us. We also expect a lot from government, also expect a lot from us as citizens to do something for our land where we come from. So what's your experience so far, the beginning of this year?
It's beautiful, but I'm hearing music in your background. I don't think I can speak in the music.
No, there's no music in my background. You can speak.
Okay. Akwa Ibom has been beautiful, you know, the COVID-19 experience, the droplet of insecurity that has characterized the Nigerian state today. Unemployment is still at very, very high rate in the state, and then no payment to pension workers is still an issue in the state today. The other day I saw the state governor tell us that they are mobilizing people back inside for them to continue construction work again. And then this ship, vessel, the security vessel production company, it's just been commissioned, and nothing much so far. That's it about the states.
So you say unemployment is still the major issue in Akwa Ibom. What about the industries?
Which industry? Edna, calm down now. Which industry?
I don't calm down. Which industry? Pencil industry, toothpick industries, meter industries.
How many people can the pencil industry employ? I was talking about this. How many people are there? I think the only industry so far now is this one, this security vessel company that is building vessels. I think that employs as much as about 5,000 people. Yes. So that is actually the real stuff that we see that is making sense a bit. But when you say pencil company, how many people will be there? You're talking about maybe nothing more than 100. How many hundred? How can you employ hundreds of people compared to the teeming youth that keeps graduating every day? You're talking about the metering company. How many people will be there? So this, you know, the last time I spoke with you about employment in Akwa Ibom state, I spoke about it in terms of mass production. I mean, a mass employment. mass employment, not this parlor industry that employ how many people, compared to the rates of unemployment. So in terms of industry, like it is said in Nigeria, it's audio industry. There are no industries in Akwa Ibom states, as far as I'm concerned.
Like 2 weeks ago, I saw a post on social media. It said they were looking for teachers. There was an vacancy for teachers. And then you are still saying that unemployment is still the main issue in Akwa Ibom.
Teachers, how many people are teachers? So are you not going to tell me that even artisans should be employed as teachers? A teaching job is a professional job, for crying out loud. A teaching job is not a job for just anybody.
What do you mean teaching job is not a job?
I said it's not a job for just anybody. That is what I said.
Oh, okay.
It's not a job for just anybody. It's a professional job. And very few people are actually qualified to be teachers. So you would not say because you want to address unemployment, then you call everybody to go and teach, and then you bring people who do not even know how to write their names to go into the classrooms to teach people. To me, that's a way of wasting time. In the modest of way to say it, you can't say that because you ask people to come for teaching. A graduate, okay, for instance, a graduate of agriculture, somebody who is trained to farm, to go and be teaching. Teaching is, you are in the UK. Do you call anybody to go and teach inside school? You don't do that now. So I think we should do something that is not a matter of we should, because we want to address a system, we bastardize the whole institution. It's wrong. So calling for people to come and employ for, I mean, to come and apply for a teaching job, and if you class that as mass unemployment, then I'm sorry, maybe you really don't know what you're talking about.
Of course, I know what I'm talking about. So
great.
You know, we have Ibom Seaport that is still under construction. Good. Now or under,
yes.
Mm-hmm.
No. Ibom Seaport is not under construction. They've just given them approval for a certain phase. Now I hear everybody, most people in the state, jumping, celebrating that the approval has been given. Well, we are happy. We are happy. If a seaport is constructed in Akwa Ibom state, it's going to be a very beautiful thing. It's going to open up the state. It's going to be massive employment. But let's just watch and see. You can't come. Number one, the federal government is not even a trusted government. The federal government, in my opinion, personal opinion, think that they actually made that approval just because they want to make good news. Since there have been bad news here and there, shall I just sign something? And they brought, what did they bring? They bring something, sign it and go. Now, the next one is, because by the time you talk about seaport, let us understand the politics of seaport in Nigeria. The politics of seaports in Nigeria. We've been talking about Ibom Seaport since 2003, if I'm not wrong. And then you're not talking about Lekki Deep Seaport. The same seaport is ongoing. They give it. They actually have been able to approve that long time ago. But Ibom Seaport had started the conversation before now. And I think the most important thing, look at One, look at Warri Port, look at Port Harcourt, look at Calabar Port. Why are they not working? All right? Because there is the politics going. I think the most important thing is to play the politics, not for you to waste money to build infrastructure. After building that infrastructure, then it remains moribund, just as we have Tinapa in Calabar. Okay, so while we are all celebrating that the seaport has been given approval to build in Akwa Ibom State, let us also understand that the actual approval is when the port is put to use. Number one, I feel that we should begin to also play the politics of decentralization of the shipping industry from Lagos. Do you get it? Because today it is only Lagos State that all the ship, despite the congestion, despite the damages, the damage done to roads by heavy trucks, because you go to Lagos like Apapa to walk now, the bridge all from Western Avenue down to Wharf, that very long bridge, you see tankers, trucks on top of this bridge, which is not healthy. Meanwhile, there are seaports in other regions. Why can't we move these things to these regions? That is the politics. So why we now go and celebrate as if seaport is the only investment that Akwa Ibom State will be able to go into? We should remember that there is a gridlock here.
But also remember that I think our airports, is going to be expanded. And they're going to make it.
I hate to hear going to be. I want to see work being done.
But before something happened, they have to start from somewhere.
6 years of governance, you are still telling us that it's going to be. You've been in power for the past 6 years, and you are still going to be. We're supposed to see jobs. The original plan of that airport has been bastardized. Do you know how many jobs that airport would have generated if the focus was on it? Instead, what we're busy doing, I can't even understand what the government is busy doing. As I'm talking to, I really cannot understand.
Because maybe this COVID has come in and then they put everything on hold.
The COVID, when you talk about COVID, it does not have anything to do in Africa, in Nigeria. Let's be realistic. It has nothing to do. If it disturbed the Western world, that is the Western world. But in Nigeria, it has nothing to do with it. All these guys are just hiding under the cover. Oh, it's COVID-19. Let us relax with COVID-19 because they don't have ideas. That's exactly what is going on.
Okay. Now we're going to move to, we're going to move to security. A lot of people say there's no security in Akwa Ibom State. We are coming to talk about the Nigerian one anyway. So we're dealing with the Akwa Ibom issue for now. So how do you see the security in Akwa Ibom State?
The security in Akwa Ibom State is actually internally generated. It's not like the one in the north, which you have Hetman, you have Boko Haram, you have the banditry. The one in the state are basically criminals. Thieves, and these are bigger boys who do not have job. Cultists within the state. Are you aware that security vessel company in Akwa Ibom State, you understand, was being attacked recently. Was being attacked, and millions of their facilities were destroyed by some boys. Demanding, is it 10 million naira? From where the question is, how could these people get to that level? And then the most ridiculous was the one that they in a government house, a certain amount of money got missing that people broke into steal. So if in a government house, petty burglars, let me put them like that, petty thieves could break into government house to steal money, where is the security?
Is it the same thing they said one time ago, snake enter jam office and swallow money? Is it the same?
That one is a shenanigan of the federal government. That one is a shenanigan. Such embarrassing stories in Nigeria. You get it, where you hear snake swallow money. I know you would have been laughing your heart out when you heard that kind of story.
Okay, Wadimo. All right then. If you are here and then you listen to what we are saying, there's something you want to say about Akwa Ibom. You feel free to drop your message and then we'll talk about it. Or if you want to make any comment, because there's no phone line today, okay? But next week, Sunday, we're going to put that back on. So we're trying to work and put everything in place by next Sunday, okay? Now, let's talk about our country, Nigeria. Recently, our president, sacked all the service chiefs.
He didn't sack those guys voluntarily because he does not even have the power to sack. They should not deceive.
Why are you saying that? But he was sacked. Yeah, they were sacked.
That is the story they give. They resign. How will somebody get?
How can all of them resign at the same time?
No, because they were all overdue now. They overstayed their time, Edna.
Uh-uh.
The four of them overstayed their time. The whole country was calling for their removal, for their change. Do you understand? They were all calling for their removal, yet they refused. They became de facto president, de facto leaders of the country. So they could only, because of the amount of pressure that has been mounting on them, that is why you see them. Imagine somebody will resign and will give you condition that 40 soldiers will protect him after his retirement? That they give them.
Who gave that condition? Who?
The retirees, my dear. The people you say they sack. How could they be sacked and then they give condition for their sack? Have you ever heard that before? Huh? Have you ever heard that?
So are you saying they went on a retirement?
They resigned. Let me put it in that way, because the pressure from the Nigerian state was too much, so they could not contain. So the best thing is for them to resign, because they are total failure. Boko Haram insecurity in Nigeria has become a means of siphoning money by some of these people.
One thing that keep bothering me is that they siphoning money and they recover this money. Yeah. So where are those money? The money they recovered. What did they use it for?
Ask them. I remember last year precisely, they said that $1 billion was borrowed to fund the military to fight insurgency. Now a dollar is 365 as of last year. So you are now telling me that the federal government or the military spend 1 billion naira every day to fight insurgency, yet they keep the terrorists keep terrorizing the country. And then you tell me that these are serious people. And even the guys that just came in, we are just watching, because all the guys that came in were part of the system. So that is why we don't even have confidence that they will do anything different from what their predecessors have done.
So you don't just see anything good in these new people coming in?
Well, I'm not expecting any difference. Like, if you would excuse my
statement. They said the president only nominates them. Not that they are, that's House of Assembly, whatever, given approval.
The House of Assembly in Nigeria is in the Aso Villa backyard. You get it? There's especially this very assembly, National Assembly, so-called, is it the Ninth Assembly or whatever they call themselves, is in the palm of the executive. So they don't even have power. So whatever the executive presents, because if they had power, all these guys would have left long time ago. All these guys are at the mercy of the so-called president. They are at the mercy of the president, or the executive, or the presidency, as the name has become now. So when you talk about insecurity in Nigeria, insecurity in Nigeria is totally political, totally economical. People look at it from the religious point of view, from ethnic point of view. I don't see it. It's basically politics and economy. Some people are making a hell of money out of it. A lot of money out of it. So that is why it cannot stop. You get it? You know, some of the money that these guys make in the so-called guys of fighting insurgency, yet it cannot stop. You understand? So the government, the federal government of Nigeria, has failed totally in terms of security in every ramification of the entire system. That's failed.
Okay, let's talk about something that is very common. It affects every single of human being in this world. Not even to talk about Nigeria or Akwa Ibom. this COVID-19. Now, so many countries are, they are paying money, they are buying vaccine for its own citizen. Is there anything like that in Nigeria? Does it mean that we don't have COVID-19 cases at all in Nigeria?
No, we really can't say we don't have COVID-19 cases in Nigeria. Of course, there is, of course, there may be COVID-19. And then, but what my argument is that the problem of COVID-19 is not really as severe. You get it? Now, if we keep on talking about COVID-19, what about malaria? Do you know how many people die of malaria every day in this country? Compared to how many people die of the so-called COVID-19 in this country? So by the time you now talk about COVID-19 or buying of vaccine, I really honestly can't comment on it.
Malaria, so what I'm saying is that if they bring vaccine into Nigeria, would you take it?
Now, number one, the point is that number one, do we even have the facilities to even store the so-called vaccine? This vaccine is said to be stored in a certain degree, temperature. You understand? Do we have the storage?
But we have fridge now. Is there no fridge in Nigeria?
Okay, how much of fridge will store over how many millions doses of this vaccine? That is, number one, the health sector is a total failure in the first place. You get it? So we are not even ready. Is it not the president's wife that said some time ago, that there is nothing even like paracetamol in the Villa Hospital Clinic? So if the presidential Villa Clinic does not have paracetamol, is it fridge that will store vaccine that we have in Nigeria? They are all pretenders, my dear. As a matter of fact, if you hear any money that being sent to us to, I mean, any money that is being released for COVID-19 vaccine, is a scam. It's a scam.
It's like you don't just see anything good in both Akwa Ibom State and in Nigeria.
Because they have failed. The system has failed.
You were given an opportunity to make it right. Yeah? But you didn't make it right. The opportunity was to elect someone you believe that is going to move the country forward or the state forward.
And now you are in London thinking that Nigeria is the same thing as London. They are two different countries. Okay, look at Museveni of Uganda. How would you conduct an election in a country and everybody that registered in that election voted for you? How is that possible? In Nigeria here, you know how they hijack the system. You get it? So if you talk about election in Nigeria, it's bad at that. It's you are just pretending. You just want to let the world know that we did. Which election? Did you see what happened in America with Donald Trump? You see, the people stood up. Can that thing ever happen? Buhari will release soldiers to kill. Look at what happened in Lekki now. And then you're telling me about we could have made a change. Which change? Has any votes counted in this country before? You know? So that is why you hear some people like us are advocating for restructuring. You get it? Let us sit down and discuss Nigeria. It's high time we left this delusionment, this contraption we are all in. Because you can't have a system whereby somebody will be sitting down somewhere detecting to everybody. Imagine how powerful the Nigerian president is. How powerful he is.
Huh? He was an ex-soldier.
And the more reason why it should not even be there. That is where I blame the UK government. Because imagine the UK government that promotes itself as a democratic state. Yet a democratic state will go and support a man that overthrew a democratically elected president in 1983. And then, you know, it's high time we stop being pretenders, believing that all this Western world have our time. They all benefit from this chaotic system. That is why you can see them. Have you ever heard the British government condemn the Nigerian government, despite how many people that died? But how many of them condemned Jonathan while Jonathan was here? So all those guys, it's high time we cut our ties and deal with us directly. Because this problem we have here, the benefits from the system as it stands.
Okay. We cannot stay more than our time. So I don't know if you have something else to say to our people.
the only thing I have to say, especially to Nigerians in diaspora, we should assiduously mount more pressure for restructuring of this country. We have to sit down and discuss. And a lot of people will now, because they don't want restructuring, they want to tell us that restructuring has different. No, when you said restructuring, you are restructuring everything: political restructuring, economic restructuring, security restructuring, financial, everything, education, every sector of the country needs to be restructured. It's high time we stop lining up. Governors, stop lining up in Abuja to go and collect money every month. That is what is killing this country. That is what is killing this country. That is another thing, is that you now see a governor does not have the power over the police, because the police has to take, the governor has to take permission from the IG in Abuja, and the IG has to take permission from the president. Meanwhile, a security issue is happening in his backyard. He can't solve it. So if a state has its own state police, security, at least a certain level security, will be handled. If a state stays and is not able to pay salary, he does not have to go to Abuja to collect money to come and pay salary. He will sit up, he will be creative. But the situation, okay, I want to tell you an instance. The other day in Kano, they went to destroy millions of bottles of beer because they say that their religion do not permit drinking beer. Fine, granted. But they collect allocation that come from the taxation of beer. And meanwhile, they target, imagine the industry. So some people will be producing while some people will be sitting down to eat. Is that normal? But if the Kano state government knows that he has to generate his own fund to pay the salaries of the workers in the state, to provide security, to provide healthcare services, if he also knows that he has to also generate a percentage and give to the federal government, do you think they will destroy those bottles of beer? They won't. And these guys, they understand all these things. So the people, our diaspora Nigerians, please, if you could just put more voices, mount more pressure. For us, the solution to this country, I'm not saying we should break. We've come a long way. We can't break. As a nation, we can live together, but we can only live together if our individual is respected. Thank you.
Okay, Wemedimo, thank you very much for being on the show. Although we started late, we would have had enough time to talk.
Edna, where is this palliative from London?
Don't just go there. Do not go there. Because we have palliative in our state. During the NSAS, people were going in to take their own palliative. The Akwa Ibom people couldn't find any palliative in Akwa Ibom state. Later, they use our palliative rice to do empowerment. So please don't go there.
Okay. Meanwhile, a certain commissioner, a certain official of the government was using the same palliative with the same bag with the donor's name and giving to people as if it was a zone. You see the hypocrisy of your people.
Let me just read one thing for you here. Someone just said something here. He said you're feeding the whole world with fake news about Akwa Ibom state and Nigeria in general.
Okay, let him give us the real news.
And he said all the service chiefs were asked to vacate their offices. by the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Ask him, did they give condition to vacate? Can a person that is sacked, were they overdue? Let's be reasonable now. Let's not be hypocritical here.
Anyway.
Were they overdue?
We don't have more time to discuss this. So please, if you have your comment, keep on posting your comment. Womadi Imo will respond to you if he wants to, you know. So I'm really sorry that we started late. We would have had enough time to interact, but well, it beyond my control. So I want to say thank you so much, Womadi Imo, for joining us today on the show. Please, let us pray. Let this network, let these spirits of you know, may God have mercy on us, you know.
Amen.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you so much, everybody, for still hanging out with me. Wow, and I see people messages and text messages. Let me just go through, because these are one of the things they said when they join. I don't talk to people, I don't greet them, I don't say anything to them. So just want to say, I've seen MC Comedian Prime, thank you for joining me today. And Nana, thank you for joining me. Godwin Esikel, Joshua John, thank you. Mboso Emmanuel, thank you. Christian Etim, thank you. And Susan Sieneto, thank you so much. Joshua, he's still posting that. Okay, you know, at the beginning of the program, we said we're gonna be giveaway a time. I mean, so that I would not say what is not there. I will be giving giveaway a time from January to June. Now, I said something. I said the first of the day in the beginning of the show. So let me see who answered first. Like I said, it's first come, first attended to. So let me see who got the first credits. Let me see from top there. Yeah, I see Godwin Ezekiel said, okay, you said, okay, MC Comedian say, two of them are saying this at the same time, because I can say 32 minutes ago at 1727 and 1727, both of them they got the answer at the same time. What are we gonna do to these people? Not even 1 minute so that one person go carry the prize. Oh God. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. Okay. I'm just being told now, like, okay. All right. So because both of you, Godwin and MC Comedian, posted the answer at the same time. So two of you are the winner of airtime for today. So please, there's a phone number on the screen, really on the screen. Text your telephone number there, and then your full name, the name you use here, and we will find out if that's you. So if anything changes here, we are not gonna give you. So text that phone number, and then we'll be crediting your phone with airtime as we promise. Okay, I've just been asked to tell people how many. Okay, you get to 2,000 naira each a time. So Godwin, you will get 2,000 a time. MC Comedian will get 2,000 a time. Okay, it's just text your number to the number on the screen. Okay, yeah. Okay, now I want to say something before I log out. You know, please. I live in UK. Here in this country, we have vaccine. I mean, I'm talking about COVID-19 vaccine. Yes, before, I myself, I have a doubt about the vaccine. I didn't want to take it before. And I said, I don't want to take it because of all the things I was reading over the internet, what people were feeding my brain with and everything like that. Scared. And if, of course, we'd be scared of our life, you know. But I come to think of it, it's for my own benefit. It's for my health, not for anybody else. So this sickness, this virus came into this world and destroyed so many things, control our lives, control our movement, everything. Some of us are on lockdown. Some of us cannot even work. Some of us lost our job because of this COVID-19. So now there's a vaccine coming out. There's a solution. And then you say you are not going to take it. Why? This is something that is going to help you. You will protect it, also protect somebody else. So please, I want to appeal to whoever that is listening to me now. You live in a country that they are giving this out, that they're giving out this vaccine, because I believe that you are not paying for it. Please go and take it. Do not delay. Every medication has symptoms. If you take paracetamol, you will have symptoms. You will take Panadol, any medicine, you have symptoms. It's just a common symptom. Like I said, I myself didn't want to take it before. I was saying no. But I now sat down, I rethink. And I went in, it was on Friday, I took it on Friday. So today is Sunday, I am still here, I am okay. So I will encourage everybody listening to me, please go out there and take your vaccine. Please, I beg you people, please. No vex, I beg. If you know that they give vaccine for where you stay, I beg, go there, go collect time. You know they do you anything. You just say, it will give you, then that place will pay you. Of course, it will pay you. You know, because the technique will choke you. You will feel pain. But after that, you will go. I beg. I beg. Try go take this vaccine. I beg. COVID-19 not be friend to anybody. You don't like anybody. You don't like anybody. I beg. So please, I will encourage everybody to go out there and take the vaccine. Go and take it. It's good for you. And for others. Okay, I don't talk my own. No. So if you believe it, well, stop reading all those flying news on internet. Stop reading it. Just go and do what you know that is good, and it's gonna help your health as well. All right. Okay. I can see people are asking. I'm new here. Sparkling Moses. Please, mommy. I like to okay. Just ask someone there that was in the group. I mean, just chat to somebody will tell you what it is. What? Okay, let me just help you. Who is that person that asked the question? Sparkling Moses. What makes them want the 8th time is that at the beginning of the show, you know, I will say a phrase of the day. So if you can grab what I said and write it correctly on the live chat, then at the end of the show like this, I'll call the first person to got the answer correct. Then they will win the 8th time. That's what it is. That is, I'm explaining that to you, Sparkling Moses. So that is what is happening. So please, thank you very much, Evelyn Smith, for joining. Thank you, Ndoku Yaivan. Thank you so much. Godwin Ezekiel said, my time has gone already, so I don't want to, this is going to be the last time I'm going to talk about this. He said, there's no words, numbers on the screen. There is numbers on the screen, please. If you look at those little, the red line underneath where you see my name, the title stuff, you see there's a number there. But if there is no number, I'm going to read the number out now. So pay attention very well. It's +44 771 88 24 440. So that's the number. Text or WhatsApp. You can WhatsApp. Though if you can't text, just WhatsApp. Then we get the number and then credit your phone with the 8th time. Remember, it's 2000, not more than that. Thank you, all of you. Okay, I want to say thank you, everybody, for watching me today and for staying with us. Please join me again next time. I sincerely apologize for coming on air very late. So I said to myself, this year we're not going to be running late on the show. I know a lot of people are complaining about that a lot. So we're sorry for today. Next Sunday is not going to be like this. We cannot come on air early. If not coming in here, start playing music until the time you will do that. But we're very sorry that we come on air this so late today. So but here is it. I just want to say I'm so sorry. And well, before I leave, I want to play music. And it was years ago when I was very small, I used to dance to this woman's music. You know, don't ask me how I used to dance it. But it was so I just wish I can just play only with because there's no video, it's audio. So let me see what I can do, if it's possible that I can just play only the audio so that you can listen to it as well. So let's see what's going to happen though. Christy is any book way.